How's it going, everybody? It's Terry with Collabo Creative, a service design company here in Indianapolis, and I'm coming at you again. It's another Wednesday. We're gonna do 5 minutes of tips and tricks to improve your creativity and collaboration in your business and life. So this week we're talking about another way to strengthen your creative muscle, because of course we wanna be creative people, right? We all know that creativity is the number one skill for leaders and teams alike. So let's build that muscle. So today we're gonna talk about being present.
Here.
Not that kind of present. We're talking about mindfulness presence. So what does it mean to be mindful? Let's start there. Well, according to mindful.org, the mindful definition of mindfulness is that it's a basic human ability to be fully present, aware of where we are and what we're doing, and not overly reactive or overwhelmed by what's going on around us. So if we think about that definition, it's really about our ability to make sure that we are engaged and fully attentive to any activity or interaction that we are conducting at the moment. So that way we're aware and attuned to what's going on. So why is this important? Why is mindfulness important for creativity? Well, if you listened to our last episode, which we brought in a little bit of that lovely man, Simon Sinek, he talks about experiences and how when we have more experiences, our brain is able to make more connections, which gives us that creative spark or helps us come up with more ideas. And so if we're able to have fuller experiences, we can have more fodder for the fire. That means our brain is able to have more instances, more concepts, more touch points for it to make connections. Now that's what we call brain food, right? Speaking of food, let's try out this one really simple mindfulness activity that we love. We've done it with so many different groups, and it's just a lot of fun because, of course, it involves chocolate. How many of you love chocolate? I know I do. So what I need you to do is grab yourself a piece of your favorite chocolate. You ready? Okay, this is what I want you to do. Take that one piece, and I want you to smell it. Think about the scent of it. Now, put it in your fingers and really feel it. What does it feel like? What's the texture? If you have chocolate, it's probably starting to melt. And what does that feel like? Is it smooth? Is it rough? Does it smell sweet? Does it smell like chocolate? Oh my gosh, I love the smell of chocolate. Now, before it starts to get all messy, go ahead and stick that, whatever you have, in your mouth and close your eyes and really think about what flavors you're tasting. What is the texture of it? Is it smooth on your tongue? Is it rough on your tongue? Is it sweet? Is it sour? Is it milky and creamy? What are all those flavors that you're experiencing? I'm sure it probably tastes delicious, right? Whatever you're eating. Now, go ahead and finish that up and open your eyes. And what we just did was an exercise in mindfulness, and we would say mindful eating. If you actually practice mindful eating, it's a way for you to be more present in what you're doing. And in that, we slow down and we engage all of our senses and are able to build those experiences, build those ideas, build those concepts, and then again, food for your brain. So that's all I've got for you today. Thanks for joining us for this week's Collabo clip. If you liked this video, give us some thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and ring that bell. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Do you have any questions or topics you'd like us to tackle? Shoot over an email to hello@collabocreative.com.
Which we brought in a little bit of that lovely man, Simon Sinek.